Okay, Joe, Plum Crazy Restorations, 1968 Dodge Charger, mechanical inspection. What do we got on the top side?
Okay, what I found here, her transmission fluid was all over the place. You see right where my thumb is here, that's a lot of fluid, and can see it's supposed to be right down here, but it's way up here. So that's way over full. This is what explained why there's so much fluid everywhere. It's just pushing it out of everywhere coming out the dipstick tube hole and running all over the rest of the car.
Okay.
So all I need to do is drain some out and get it down to its proper level, clean up the bottom of the car, and we'll see what's really going on with it.
That's quite a bit over full.
That's a lot over full. And what I also have also seen is right down here is there's actually a puddle down here from the distributor. There's a seal down there and underneath the distributor, and it's actually puddling up down there. So that's a bit of a leak going on down there. It's also leaking down here. It's not from the valley pan area, otherwise it would be oil down there. You see it's a tiny bit here splashing back, but it's not puddling up.
Right.
And it's also from the back of the valve covers is leaking oil running down both sides. And we also have over here is this power steering hose is kind of soft. So it's a high pressure hose here, and you see it is a little bit wet around here, so it's showing signs it is starting to leak around here. It's time for another hose, another high pressure power steering hose. It would really help things out a lot here.
Okay.
And maybe a couple of battery terminal ends. You see it's probably broken. It's getting kind of loose.
It's not going to start pretty soon.
So a couple of them would be a good idea.
Okay. Also, the plug wires down there on the steering.
It is. It's actually rubbing down here, and I can feel on the back side here. It's almost through, and this one here is rubbing. Not nearly as bad, but it is rubbing. And this one here is actually on the power steering itself down here, which is not a good idea. We need to put some better...
This car should have had 90s on it.
It absolutely need to bend it around a lot better, or maybe even put some better wires on here. It seems this one here is rubbing through. It would be a really good idea to fix that kind of thing up, that's for sure.
Sounds good.
And what we've got over here for doors is has a little bit of a door issue. When I open up the door a little bit and I pull up on it, you see it's got a lot of movement. You can really see the movement down on the door.
You know what?
Right here is a good spot where you can really see that's a worn hinge.
One more time? Yeah.
Okay. That's a lot of movement.
That's definitely needs hinges.
So heavy doors. So that they would be aware. And on this side, you can actually see where it's missing a bolt right here, so this is actually kind of coming loose and it's cracking there, so this needs to be addressed, otherwise it's going to continue to have problems.
Okay.
And the other side is the same for the latch area.
Yeah.
And the door itself is becoming a little bit loose also on the other side, but not nearly as bad.
Okay. That sounds good.
The steering column itself has got a little bit of a loose issue with the whole thing here is a little bit loose. It needs to be taken apart and tightened up a little bit.
Yeah.
The column itself is okay, but it's just a little bit around the shifter.
Okay. And
it's got a couple of lights out. It's got a high beam light out. It's got a marker light out in the back. It's got a tail light out in the back.
Okay.
It's got a two system light, but only one is out, so it's not a big deal. Otherwise, the car is not bad at all, considering its age.
Okay, well, we'll put everything together, show it to the customer, and go from there.
That sounds great.
Sounds good. Thanks.
Okay.